Okay, fantastic guys. So I formally welcome all of you to Comprehensive Revision Program. So like every year, what we do is towards the end of the session, that is from December last week till first week, we conduct classes on a daily basis where all the subjects will be, or the maths and science subjects will be covering again, you know, repeating everything what we have done. And especially this year, there have been some deletions, so hence we'll be taking care of that as well. I hope you're all aware about the new curriculum. So your school already would have told you and would have got papers according to the new curriculum only. So, hence keep that thing in mind. And I'm going to share my screen now and just tell me if you are able to see the screen. Able to see the screen, all of you? Yep. So I will.
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. So guys, as you know, the schedule has been given to you already. And just a minute. Ankur, by any chance, you're there in the group right now?
Yeah, I'm here.
So I will make you co-host so that anyone gets, anyone enters, you can just let them in.
Got it. Yeah.
Sure. Okay. So, I have made you co-host, so you can do what? You can just let them enter one by one.
Got it.
In 15, 20 minutes, all the people would have joined any which way. Okay, folks. So, So, we are going to discuss quadratic equations first. And what will be the approach is this. Okay, so let's talk about it straight away. So, first of all, you must be aware of what is the course structure for Class 10 Mathematics from CBSE. So, you can see, number systems and the weightage, all the seven categories and the weightage has been given, and this has been extracted from cbse.nic.in, the website of CBSE, and there is some chat going on parallelly, so let me open that as well. Yes, it can be viewed in Learnlist later. So no discussion on the technical aspects of it. All discussions related to this thing will be entertained. Is that fine? So yes. Okay, guys. So number systems, you can see 6 marks. So 6 marks, algebra 20 marks. And this is where quadratic equations will be falling. Coordinate geometry, 6 marks, geometry, 15 marks, trigonometry, 12 marks, mensuration, 10 marks, and statistics and probability, 11 marks. So as far as the priority of the topic goes in terms of marks, you can see algebra has the highest weightage. So here is where linear equations and polynomials and quadratic equations and all that, which we have studied, will be there. Okay, so hence total marks is 80. And let's set a target for all of us. So our target is 80 on 80, right? That is what is called centum, right? So everyone should be thriving for 80 on 80. And trust me, it's not impossible. And 10th board papers are too predictable, actually. So you can know, you can actually calculate what could be the question number one, question number two, and things like that. But overconfidence also should not set in. So hence, we will try our best and make sure that we get 80 on 80. The other 20% of the total is with your school. I hope you have done well all through this year. You have done your internal assessments were there. You have done them well. So assuming that in theory paper, we have to get 80 on 80. Possible, not possible. Let me see how much energy do you have. Possible or not? I can see a total lull, silence in the group, in the entire room. Yes, guys, possible? Yep, everyone should be thriving for the only agenda, right? So on 12th of January, Swami Vivekananda's birthday is there. And he had a very famous quote. So and you have to set an eye on a target and just go behind it without thinking much about anything. So if you have not been able to, let's say, cope up well all this while throughout this year, don't worry. As I told you, if you just restrict yourself to the pattern and the questions which have been given, and you solve all these questions once again, I am very sure. And of course, you have to take care of the very famous problem, the silly mistakes, the careless mistakes, and you have no reason why you can't score 80. Okay, so you understood the division of marks. So you can see algebra is the highest priority, post which there is geometry. So hence your triangles and Pythagoras theorems and similarity of triangles and circles and all that will be included over there. Trigonometry, including identities as well as what are the heights and distance application of trigonometry. So hence, and this time around, there is some change in the pattern of the question. Also, let's discuss that straight away. So what is that? This is a question paper structure. So that goes without saying that you have to read it at least twice. You get some time to read all of that so that you are well aware what you are going to do. So as you can see, there are two parts, A and B. Okay, so what are part A and part B? And part A and part B have internal choices. Now, the moment you see this, don't think that, okay, I can, you know, skip any particular topic. Why? Because you know that even if there is an or, there is some kind of, choice, the choice will be internal choice. It cannot be, external choice. Okay, so, as in sense, you can't have choice between trigonometry and, let's say triangles. Yeah, great. Now let's move ahead. So we were discussing question paper structure. And what was the question paper structure? I told you there are two parts, part A and part B, and there are internal choices. So what does internal choice mean? So it will be, let's say, for example, if there is quadratic equation question. So there will not be quadratic versus trigonometry choice. Okay, so hence there is no way you can skip any particular topic. So you have to either choose this. You have to, you know, be thorough with all the topics any which way. Now there are three sections, A consists of sections 1 and 2. One has 16 questions. Okay, so one has 16 questions of 1 mark each. Now, unlike previous year, last year it was MCQ. So you would have seen this, change in your question paper. All of you just confirm if you have seen this in the recent pre-board exam so you don't need not say anything in on the mic. You can just type in, so use your chat. So you would have seen that change, isn't it? Now internal choice is provided in 5 questions. Okay, and section 2 has 4 questions. Now this is a new type of section which has been introduced this year, which says it's based on case study. Okay, now each case study has 5 case-based subparts, so these are all objective types only. And you have examinee is to attempt any 4 out of 5 subparts, any 4. So keep that in mind, any 4 of 5 subparts. Okay, so be thorough with the instruction so that you maximize your.
Sir, the case study will be how each carries how much marks?
So each one is 4 mark, right? So 4 marks each. So there are 5. So 4 out of 5 subparts you'll have to answer. So you can do the calculation. Total marks is 80, right? 16 into 1 is 16. Then 4.
4 fours are 16.
So another 16, 32. Correct? Then how many? 2 of, how many are there? 6 questions of 2 marks. Sorry, so this is 12. And what else? 27 to 33. That means 4 plus 7.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, the only the case study part in total is just 16 marks.
Yes.
It is not 16 marks per question.
That's what I'm saying.
1 mark.
Total is 16.
Yeah.
So that's what I mentioned, right? 16 is the 1 marker objective. 16 is the total, 4 into 4, 16. And then 2 into 6, 12. Okay. And then what? 27 to 33. So 7 questions of 3 marks.
7 questions.
21. So let me write it here. 21. And then what else? 3 questions of 5 marks each. So 15. So 156. How much is this? This is 46. And 36 here. And what here? It is 32 plus 12, 44. So 44 here and 36 here. Total is 80. Okay. Now, other question which usually people ask, whether we should apply start from the beginning or from the end, right? Now, this is something which is totally an individual choice. Until unless instructed, you can begin from anywhere. And many people think, okay, I'll be spending, you know, good amount of time on the 5 markers so that, you know, there's small misstep here and there, misstep, and then loss, marks are lost. So hence, if I would have been here, I would have definitely gone through the normal sequence. So my preference is that. So I will earmark. So there are how many? 16 plus 16, 32 marks, right? So 32 marks, 1 marker question are there, right? So hence I would spend around 40, 45 odd minutes there. So you can do the calculations, 45 minutes for the objective one, let's say. Okay. And then, so this is section A. Okay. And for section B, obviously the rest of the time, but I usually spend 15 minutes or I leave 15 minutes towards the end for revision. So hence I am left with 165 minutes in total. So if I'm left with 165 minutes in total, then how do I divide 45 gone? So I am left with 120 minutes. So 2 hours exact for the other 2 marker, 3 marker and 5 markers, right? So you can calculate. So how many questions are there? 21 to 20, 21 to 36. So there are 16 questions. Obviously not every question will have the same amount of time. So what will you do for 2 markers? Not more than 3 minutes or not even 3 minutes. 3 minutes only. So hence how many? 21 minutes, 18 minutes for the 3 marker. Okay. So let me write that. 3 marker question. Let's say on an average 3 minutes, so 18 marks there. Maybe you can take 18 to 20, something like that. Then 3 marker questions are 7 in number. So I'll spend, let's say, 5 minutes each. This is 2 markers. Sorry. Yeah. So for 3 markers, you'll have, let's say, 5 minutes each. So 35 minutes. And for 5 minutes, you can take, let's say, how many questions are there? There are three only. So 3 questions of 5 marks. So even if you take 10 minutes each, 30 minutes more. So in total, also, if you add, it will not be 120. So basically, 10th board paper should be over by 2 hours, 2 hours, 15 minutes. And you have all the time to go again and again revise. And that is very, very important because CBSE at times is notorious for having some issues in the question. When I was writing in my 10th board, there was one issue in one question, which we never knew. And we spent unnecessarily huge amount of time ending up with losing marks here and there. So hence, keep that in mind. And you can divide your, you know, so 15 last minutes, come what may, you have to revise because there are lots of, questions which you are attempting. And what happens is you are in some other world. You are thinking of your time. You're thinking of some other, formalities to be fulfilled during the exam and it just gets lost. So keep that in mind. Okay. Now coming to, so this is the syllabus now, modified syllabus for quadratic equations. So you can see there are 3 subunits. One is standard form of quadratic equation. That is one. All of you know this. It is so common that we have done it so many times. And then solutions of quadratic equations. We have to, only real roots. So this is mentioned. This is taken just copy paste from 3 hours. Yes. So yeah, Aryan, any question? No, who was asking? Aiden, any question there? So let me know if at all there is any issues. Okay. Solutions of quadratic equations, only real roots, they have mentioned categorically. So there and using factorization and by using quadratic formula. So you can be rest assured to a large extent that anyways, graphical solutions are not there. Relationship between discriminant and nature of roots. This is the third element. Now, if you see the sample paper, I hope you are aware that CBSE has released some sample papers. So let me show you what is there. So you should go to LearnList. We are trying to, so we have given everything here. You can see that exam CBSE website. So you can keep checking that for latest information. Don't go by here and say of what the news are saying, newspapers are saying. No, just go to the CBSE website and see if there is a notification. So usually there will be a notification here. Can you see that? This is the most authentic, reliable source of any information related to your exam. So always bookmark this site and keep looking at this notification. Okay, fair enough. So examination related material, this must you must know all these previous year question papers of CBSE. So you can see marking scheme for compartment exam, question papers for compartment exam, marking scheme for examination 2020. This is for your use. So you must see these things. So just a minute. Yeah, so what I'm saying is, yeah, so these are the, things you should be taking care of. Then marking scheme, do look at marking scheme one. So how marks are awarded will give you a good sense of how to go about it. Okay, model answers again. So we'll be discussing model answers anyways in this session. And good that they have given that so that you can have a, view of how exactly the answer should be written. is my answer writing skill matching with whatever is the demand of the board? So that you must be taking care of. So lots of information here. So you can use that as well. Very good. Now, let's go to, So next thing is here. So this is curriculum. So all the latest revised curriculum is here. So do have a look before you attempt any preparation. So this is again another important site. Then official papers of CBSE. This is the sample question paper they have released. So you must practice them for sure. And you know, even if you have seen the question, no worries. Take down the paper, take out a time slot, 3 hours, and then solve the question paper. Okay. Deleted portions. Everything we will be anyways discussing in our sessions, but you must be aware of. So this is where deleted portions are. So you can see this is for class 9. So don't get confused. Class 10th one is here, right? So you can see in quadratic equation, what is deleted? You can see that here. So what is deleted in quadratic equation? Situational problems based on equation reducible to quadratic equation. This is not going to be there in your question paper this year. What is this? So situational problem is nothing what we say as or what we call as word problems. So there will not be any word problem where this form of equation are not there. So let's say two, this kind of a equation will not be there this year. Okay. So anything which is requiring this will not be there. So that's, you can be assured of, but then you know already how to solve this, how to transform such equations into a quadratic one and then solve, right? So give me a thumbs up if so far so good. Everyone is with me. Yes. So lots of people, right? So and hence I must also be aware that you are taking, you are understanding everything what we are discussing. Yes, we will be discussing completing the square method. So there is no mention of deletion of completing the square method. So we'll be discussing that. Very good. So keep the energy level high, guys, because you have to sustain for at least three more months. And if nothing goes wrong, because last year students had to suffer literally. So if nothing goes wrong, you will be thorough. Okay, you should be acing it. Chalo, let's begin. So we will be revising the theory part quickly, and then we will be doing our questions, previous year questions only. Wait a minute, again I lost the chat. Where is the chat thingy? Chat. Yeah. Okay, chalo. So let's begin, guys. So what is this? First of all, a polynomial of degree 2. So we start with this only. So what is So polynomial of degree 2 is called a quadratic polynomial. So what is quadratic polynomial? It is given over here. So hence it is any px is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, c are real numbers, right? So we are not going to take up any complex in this board, 10th board. A, B, C are real numbers. An important thing is A should be equal to 0. Why? Because if A becomes 0, then the equation is reduced to a linear form. So hence, this is very, very important. So many a times, this particular thing gets neglected. Always remember that A is never going to be 0. And X is a real variable. So X cannot take any complex variable over here. Okay, so this is the first thing. Let's go to the next one. Okay, so next one. What is the next one? Quick. So, yes, let me do one thing. Yeah, this will be making it a little. Yeah, so I will be using the. Yeah, if px is ax square plus bx, oh, this should not be. Yeah, so ax square plus bx plus c. A is not equal to 0, is a quadratic polynomial, and then alpha is real number, then you know that P of alpha AX square A alpha square. Sorry for that. So hence P of alpha is A alpha square plus B alpha plus C. Okay, is known as value of the quadratic polynomial. So why do we need to understand polynomials? Because the next slide itself, RNM, yes, those who are, instead of raising hand, just unmute and say. Yeah, anyone, or don't raise hand if you are not asking any questions. So if any question,
it's a long back raised by mistake.
No problem. So if anyone has any doubt, just unmute, say, and put your mic back on mute. Okay. So this is what we mean. So hence, if a polynomial is there, what is a polynomial? Quadratic polynomial, Px. Let me change the color of this pen so it becomes easier. becomes more, yeah. So P x is equal to a x squared plus b x squared plus c. This is my polynomial. If you put alpha over there, you'll get the value of the polynomial, right? This is a alpha square plus b alpha plus c. Sorry, this is not square here. So a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is a polynomial, quadratic polynomial, right? And let's take an example. So example is, let's say px is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2. And let us say we are trying to find out p of 1. So p of 1 is 1 square minus 3 times 1 plus 2. You all know this. This is 0. And this is what is linked to the root of our quadratic equation, which we'll see next. Let's go to the next slide. Yeah. So a real number alpha is said to be a zero of the quadratic polynomial. So zero of a polynomial and a solution or a root of an equation, right? So zero of a polynomial, zero of quadratic polynomial px, ex square plus bx plus c, if p alpha is zero, right? So any value which reduces the value of the polynomial to zero will be called the zero of the polynomial. And the same thing we'll see in the next slide. It is related to, let's say, the equation. Now we are doing what? We are doing px equals to zero. So whatever polynomial, quadratic polynomial we had, so px was the quadratic polynomial, and what was it? Ax squared plus bx plus c, and we are equating it to zero. The moment we equate any polynomial to zero, random entered this, who's random, dude? You know, you can't have such names. I will not allow you. So any such miscreant will be thoroughly thrown out of the... Ankur, you're there? Ankur, if you're available. Otherwise, I will do the honors myself. Anyone having...
No, I am here. I am well. I have seen and I have admitted as of now.
No. Any person who is having any random name or anonymous people, just bar them from the meeting. Remove them.
Okay, got it.
Okay. Summarily, okay. Remove. No miscreants allowed. Okay. Yeah, so just remove them and give them a private warning once, saying that you are not welcome, and then you can remove them without any issue. Okay, guys. So what I was saying is px equals to ax square plus bx plus c is equal to zero is the equation now. Equation which we are going to discuss all parts of it. Always remember, I will keep re-emphasizing, a is not equal to zero. And this is the definition of quadratic equation. So we already know all of this, so we'll not spend much of a time over here. Now, a real number alpha is said to be a root of the quadratic equation, or it should be instead of root. We will, many a times people interchangeably use the word root, but then best word is to use solution. Solution or root, both are interchangeably used, of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equals to zero if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c equals to zero. So you know this, we don't need to overemphasize on this. In other words, alpha is a root of this if and only if alpha is a zero of the polynomial this. So there could be a case where polynomial and quadratic equation. So quadratic polynomial, you have a chapter on polynomial, and quadratic equation. The questions could be very, very close. So hence, they can use the concept of polynomials on quadratic equations and vice versa. So be careful. Okay, now, so how to solve? So one is factorization. So now we are solving. So the first one is solving a quadratic equation. So how to do? First, you already know, in your when we discuss this chapter in our class, we also discuss graphical method of solution of this thing, but that will not be there in your paper for sure. And because in the sample papers, or rather in the syllabus also, it doesn't mention that. So hence, it should not be there, but you know how to, solve a quadratic equation using graph paper, graph. So you have to plot.
Sir,
yes, sir.
Sir, is this meeting is for 40 minutes?
No. Why are you worried about it? So,
no, sir.
Yeah, just, anything non-technical, please resist from that, So anything related to the subject matter, please ask those questions only. Is that fine with all? So that we can save time for each one. Let's respect each one's time. And try to finish quickly. Okay, don't worry. Your interest will be taken care of. So even if it is suspended in 40 minutes, why do you get a notice of something like that? Don't worry about it. Okay, chalo. So if ax square plus bx plus c is factorizable into a product of two linear factors, this is the best thing which we have known. And we also called call this particular thing as splitting the middle term, right? Splitting the middle term. So if you, and all that we are talking here, we are talking in context of the examination. Now in the examination papers, we have not seen for a long time that they have given equation and they are asking you to solve it. No, they in at max in your paper, you'll have two questions, two for quadratic. One will be related to the nature of root, finding k and all that. And that is one marker. So usually the division is 1 mark plus 3 marks. So that is what we have seen. So there will be one marker. Definitely you, they will not give you a problem to or equation to solve in 1 mark. They will ask you to find some k value for depending on the nature of roots and all that. We'll see that. And there will be a word problem of 3 marks usually. Or, you know, there is, you know, no 4 mark question. So hence this is going to be the pattern mostly. Right. So hence you will be getting a word problem to solve, or they might give you an equation to solve also. So be prepared. So they will give you splitting the middle term maybe, or, you know, quadratic formula or completing the square and things like that. But anyways, so splitting the middle term, all of you know. So if you have x square minus, let's say, 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. So you know what to do. You have to split this term, including the sign also. So please be careful. And what you do x square minus 4x minus x plus 4 is equal to 0. And then it becomes x times x minus 4 minus 1 times x minus 4. And this is equal to 0. So you say this is x minus 1 times x minus 4 is equal to 0. And this is what is called factorization into linear terms. So when you divide or factorize into two linear terms, and then what you can do? You can equate each one of them to 0. So you'll get x minus 1 is equal to 0 and x minus 4 is equal to 0, right? And hence you'll get x equals to 1, and hence you'll get x equals to 4. So this is one way of factorizing. We'll see actual board papers that will make more sense. Let's go to the next one. Completing the square, what is it? So let's do this for all of you once again. So let us say we have ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. This is one of the methods adopted early on. So hence, we'll utilize the space here. So I'm going to begin from here. What you need to do is you have to complete the square. So how do I complete the squared? So I can start with either multiplying the entire thing or dividing. So I can multiply by a. Let's say I multiply the entire equation by a. What do I get? I will get a square x square plus abx plus ac is equal to 0. Right, then now this is where the first element of my completing the square is coming out. So this is, you can write, this implies ax. Mind you, they will not ask you prove this technique, prove the technique of completing the square. I don't think so. You never know, but I don't think they will be asking you such things. They will give you an equation and ask you, whatever I am writing is not able to, are you guys, is this thing visible to everybody, whatever I'm writing on the leftmost part of my screen?
Yes, sir. So
just confirm, I'm putting, what do I write here? What did I write?
Hi.
Very good. And what did I write here?
25.
Great. So that means the span expanse is okay. And what did I write here?
Minus 26.
Cool. So hence everybody is able to see. Okay, folks, so I think is completing the square method is in your portion. So in deleted portions, it's not there. That means it is definitely there. I showed you the website of CBSE. The only deleted portion is wherever equations reducible to quadratic form is there, those application problems will not be there only. So that means everything else is there. Okay, so but having said that, I've never seen a question which says that, okay, prove the completing or demonstrate the completing the square method. No, they will give you a question and ask you, okay, to solve. So use, yes.
We haven't been asked, we haven't been taught that in school either. We haven't done any questions.
Okay, so no problem. But, you know, since it is there as a, you know, hence I'm saying they will never ask you to adopt it. But chalo, just in case you have to, you know, there is nothing, no dangerous thing here. So no worries. So you have heard of Sridharacharya's rule, the quadratic formula. So how is that derived? So hence, quickly, both of them are similar. So hence, no worries. Just check, you know, anyways, it will add to your knowledge, even if it is not there. Chalo. So what can I do? I can say 2ax rather. So, you know, see the manipulation I'm trying to do. and I'm separating this B out and dividing this by 2. So hence, if you look at this term, 2AX times B by 2. So it is same as ABX, okay? And then plus AC, let it be. Or rather, you know, what I'm going to do is, instead of that, I will add one more term here, which is B square by 4. And then subtract also B square by 4 plus AC. Give me a thumbs up if everyone is okay with this part. Is this clear? Is this clear? Yep. Anyone did understand? You can, you know. So what did I do? I simply manipulated a bit. So ABX is written like this. And then, you know, I just added and subtracted B square by 4. The reason will be clear just in the next step. And done. So hence, it is nothing but AX plus B by 2 whole square. If you look at it, it is simply this. Yep. And on the right-hand side, I can take B square by 4 plus minus AC. I hope this is clear. And this is where the entire thing ends. Right now, I can solve this, you know, equation. Why? Because I have separated the variable on one side and the constants on the other side. So hence, what can I say? I can say AX plus B by 2 is equal to plus minus under root. If I simplify this, this is B square minus 4AC by 4. Right? And hence, I can write AX is equal to minus B upon 2 plus minus under root B square minus 4AC by 2. And this is what is also called quadratic formula. So X is minus B plus minus under root B square minus 4AC by 2A. Right? So repeat after me. So X is minus B plus minus under root B square minus 4AC by 2A. This particular hero item is called discriminant D, right? Discriminant. So you're discriminating against something. Discriminant, right? So discriminant D, right? And this D is going to create a lot of trouble. Why? Because under root, under square root anything, if it becomes negative, and then the real world gets, you know, in trouble. So hence, that only takes us to the nature of root. So is this understood? Completing the square method is not a big deal. So you multiply by A, complete the square using A plus B whole square, and that, and separate the, you know, variable on the one side, all the constants on the other side, and you know, just go for, you know, simplifying the equation and solve it. Bolo, yahan pe koi takleef, any problem so far in this slide? So far so good. Any difficulty so far? Okay, so for finding the zeros using the completing square, can we use quadratic formula? Anirudh, if the word completing the square is given, which I don't think will be there in this year, if at all that is given, then you have to write all this. Don't use the formula directly. Is that okay?
But completing square method is deleted from last 2 years, no, sir?
I'm just saying, if at all, see, there is no, you know, in my opinion, many a times question do have it, but we haven't seen it in the last 3-4 years. But I'm saying, if at all there is, see, we have to be ready for every exigency. And hence, we are also going to discuss,
yes, sir,
the reducible forms as well. Even if they have said, not there, but you never know. In some place, it is applicable and you have missed it and gone. This is a risky thing to do. Friends, we will be, see, there is no problem in going a little bit extra and winning it over. Is this difficult by any chance? Don't look, sir, for cutting corners that, okay, this is deleted, I will not do it. Arre bhai, something is, you know, you learn it. Anyways, 10th is not the last year you will be doing. Acha, chalo, no problem. If you think it is deleted, don't study it. Now, so quadratic formula, all of you know how it is arrived at. We just proved it. There was a very famous Indian mathematician, Sridharacharya, in 6th century AD. He also came up with, you know, the same formula. But instead of multiplying by A, we have to divide it by A in that equation. So what I mean is this. So he adopted this is equal to 0. So instead of multiplying, last time we multiplied by A, na? So instead of that, he divided this by A. Obviously, A is not equal to 0, so we can do this game. If A was 0, I could not have divided, right? So hence, it is simply X square plus B upon AX plus C upon A is equal to 0. And again, now follow the completing the square mechanism. Okay? If you do that, again, you will land up here. X equals to minus B plus minus root B by 2A, where D is B square minus 4AC. discriminant. Many a times people get confused between A, B, and C. For example, let's say the question is A minus B x square plus B minus C x plus C minus A is equal to 0. This is the equation. So don't get confused in this equation that, okay, this is the same A and B and C. So here, the small a, which is this, is not this A. So these two are different. Do you understand this difference? What is small a here? Small here, yes. So as Aditya ji is saying, so you can take, you know, either capital A or some px square plus qx plus r like that. So here, the solution will be x is equal to minus b minus c. Not only b. Now, this b here is the entire thing here. B minus c, right? So, minus b minus c plus minus under root b square. So, in this case, b minus c, this square. Minus 4ac. So, what is 4ac? A minus b, c minus a divided by 2a. So, twice a minus b. This is the solution for this equation. So, don't get confused between a, b, and c. So, hence, one way of doing it is, you write this as ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So this is the quadratic equation. So your solution will be x is equal to minus capital B plus minus under root capital B square minus 4ac by twice a. Is the value of the coefficient taken when replacing the value of a and b and c? Yes. So basically this entire thing is capital A. Value of the coefficient only is a, b, and c. A, b, and c are what? Not only value, but the sign. Sign plus value, both. Plus a, let's say for example, the question is, let's take an example, 3x square, or let's say minus 3x square, minus 4x plus 2 is equal to 0. So what is a here? A is minus 3. What is b here? Minus 4. And what is c here? 2. Is that okay? Confirm, Kirtan. Clear? No doubt? Any doubt? Any doubt? Any doubt? Confirm, guys, all so far. Slide number 8. Okay, good. Now, nature of the roots of quadratic equation. Now comes the game. So, why all this is required? So, if you see x is equal to, we found out, minus b plus root over d. In fact, minus plus minus root over d and 2a. One thing, another one important thing you must notice here is, this is plus minus. So a quadratic equation, always remember, how many roots can a quadratic equation have? 3. True or false? Can a quadratic equation have 3 roots? True or false?
True or false.
So they might ask you these kind of questions as well. So which of the following statement is true? You never know. So be ready. So a quadratic equation can will always have 2 roots. True or false? A quadratic equation will always have 2 roots.
True.
A quadratic equation will always have two roots.
So false.
It's true because quadratic equation will always be having two roots. If it is given, quadratic equation have two real roots always, then it is false. Understood? The play of words? No. So hence, if the question is quadratic equation has two roots, true or false? This statement is true or false? This statement is absolutely true. Every quadratic equation will have two roots. But in your grade, what have we done? We have restricted our study only to real roots. So when we are saying, and if I change the equation or statement, QE has two real roots always. True or false? True or false? Then it is false, right? Why? Because we can have only one real root also or none at all. None at all. So hence, be very, very careful. Be watchful. Yes, please.
So what if a quadratic equation has two same roots? So then do we say it has one root or two roots?
Two equal roots. Technically speaking, okay, we have to say two equal roots. A quadratic equation will always have two roots. So hence, what happens is in this case, one root is coincident on the other. So we always say that quadratic equation will have two roots. Yes. Depending on the D, this d, everything depends on this d. Why? Because square root of d, if negative, is not real. Hence, if d is greater than 0, all of you know, these are what? Two distinct or other word used is unique root /solution. Mind you, it need यहाँ पे zero नहीं. This should not be there. This is wrong. Equality sign many times people add here. No, wrong. ठीक है जी. Then d is equal to zero. This is two equal roots. Okay. And third is d less than zero. We say two imaginary roots. So don't say no roots. Okay. Or say two non-real roots. But in all the cases, there are two roots. Can we have two real roots? Yes. Obviously, there are so many cases. Just now we proved, isn't it? The core is two real roots on x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. Real or unreal? Unreal. All of you play video game, Unreal Engine. Yeah, have you ever tried Unreal Engine, guys? No. Anyone? Lots of people. See, I knew Aryan was going to answer that. Okay, cool. So real roots, right? Here, this is real roots. What are the roots? Quickly, let's see without solving. What are the roots here? Who will say first? Quick. What are the roots here? X square minus 3x plus 2. Roots are. Arey, itna time. Come on, quick. What are the roots? Tum quick hona chahiye, right? You should.
Sir, it took some time to unmute.
Okay, so technical issues. Okay, never mind. So now I'm not going to repeat. Let's go to first question. Sample paper, 1 mark. This is given in your sample paper. Can you see in the sample paper? Hence, I said these are so predictable. For what value of k, the equation inx square plus cx, ckx plus 4 equals to 0 has equal roots. Quick. Solve, Madi. K equals to 2. Surya has solved it. But my dear friends, since it is one marker, just don't write. So how will you write it? So this is how you should write. This is how you should write. Oh, sorry. Wait a minute. Huh? This is now mark the steps. So you have to write like that. For equal roots. For equal roots. What do you need to do? D is equal to b square minus 4ac must be equal to 0. Okay, so since it is one marker, so don't write the equation and repeat all of that. So hence b square, what is b here? 6k whole squared minus 4 times 9 times 4 must be 0. Am I right? Bolo dosto. So 6k whole square is equal to 4 square into 3 square, right? So 6k should be plus minus 4 times 3. So k should be plus minus 4 times 3 by 6, which is plus minus 2. Is that okay? This is how, for one mark, write it. Sir, the question can also have two equal unreal roots. Two equal unreal roots. No. No. Two equal unreal roots are not possible. Always complex roots are in conjugate form. Or you can have, actually, yes. No, you can have. How? This one is, this. For example, x square plus 4 equals to 0. No, but here also no. Sorry. My mistake. You cannot have two equal roots ever. Equal unreal roots. Is that okay? Yes, in quadratic equation, for example, this. What is the root here? The root is plus minus 2i. Okay? So, again, there are two roots, two complex roots. Is that okay, guys? Bolo, clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes or no?
Hanji, yes, sir. Tell you. Sir, next question.
Sorry?
Next question.
Next question. Do it. Find the roots of the equation. X square plus 7x plus 10.
Minus 2 and minus 5.
Yeah, you already solved it. How?
Mental maths.
Oh my God. Good. Very good. So how will you write? This is again one marker given,
sir,
in sample.
Sir, factors of 10 are 2 and 5. So x plus 2 times x plus 5.
So in the question paper, both 11th and 12th question were in OR. Aryan Tandon. signs are wrong. Hence, dekho, the signs of mistakes are now, they have started emerging now. That's sad. Okay, dekho, x square plus, if this is one marker, what will I do? I will write x square plus 2x plus 5x plus 10. Always remember, in one marker, they are not going to give you very tough splitting the middle term. So you can very easily split the middle term. And towards the end, I will give you one fail-safe method of splitting the middle term, just in case you got stuck also. Okay. So this is, and it is better to write this implies sign all the time. Okay. So hence it is x plus 5, x plus 2 equals 0. So you can write x plus 5 equals to 0 or x plus 2 equals to 0. These are hygiene things. And hence x equals to minus 5 or x equals to minus 2. Okay, dear. Aditya, sir, could you go to the previous question once? Yes. Here is the previous question. Bolo. What is the issue? Aditya, unmute and say if you have anything.
Nothing, sir. I just wanted to copy it.
Oh, copy. No worries. This will be... Oh, don't worry, guys. Try to solve parallelly, but all the notes will be available on the same Learnis portal. So don't be, worried about availability of all of these. The entire slides are for you. Don't worry. Chaliye, next. Quickly see different... this is one marker again. Bolo. Find the roots. Oh,
sir, it's the same question.
Oh, yeah, just slide copy. Yeah. Okay. Never mind. Chalo, idhar karo, ye karo. Do this. So for what values of A, quadratic equation has no real roots, no real. Sir, why do I always get the signs wrong while factorization? Avantika, the best way to do is when you solve it, put one of the values back into the equation and check whether you have got it right. Check, the best part about equations is, when you're solving it, you can always check whether that is correct or not by putting the value back into the equation, isn't it? So just simply put 2 back into the equation. It will take hardly 15 seconds to calculate. You will get to know whether the solution is correct or not. Fair enough. Okay. Okay, next. Done. Values of A. Again, one marker. So you can't afford to invest more than a minute on this. 1 minute max. So Medha says A greater than 1. Okay, how will you solve this? Again, step. Mark the steps. So again, CBSE, as I told you, go to the marking scheme. See how marking scheme is there. Anything greater than 3 by 10. Akshita, no. You have to write like this. A greater than 3 by 10 or something like that. Okay, so hence, what values of A? A. 30ax square minus cx plus 1 has no real root. So you'll start like this. Even if it is for one mark, write the theory first. For no real roots, write this statement. You will get half a mark straight away. For no real roots, write D is equal to b square minus 4ac less than 0. This is a condition. Am I right? So far, so good. For no real roots, this has to be the condition. B square minus 4ac is less than, you know. But since there is a here, try not writing this. Why? Because people will think that you are trying to this a and that a are same. So you can stick to this. D is less than 0 and then go straight. So D is what? B square. So minus 6. Now be careful when you are picking up the sign. B square minus 4ac. Right. 30a is a here and 1. This must be less than 0. Have I done correctly? This is the equation. So minus 6 square is 36. Minus 120a is less than 0. So hence be very, very careful that 120a has to be greater than 36. Okay. So a is greater than 36 upon 120. Right? So this is nothing but 3 upon 10. So done. Good enough. You can leave here. A is greater than 3 by 10. Right? Okay, guys. So hence this bracket may S. Okay, clear. Sir, I have a doubt. If such a question are for MCQ, do we need to show working? No, MCQ to hai nahi, hata diya na unhone. Where is MCQ now? There is no... Did you guys get the MCQs in your school papers? I don't think so.
Yes, sir. We got like lots of MCQs.
No. For R&R, the autonomous paper, you know, may be a little different from this thing.
No, but sir. Then, we are following board pattern only. Only just that the.
But there is no MCQs in the sample paper given by, this thing. There was no MCQs. But anyways, if MCQ is there, then it was no problem. Happy. Right.
Sir, only the case study based questions have MCQs. The rest are fill in the blanks.
So the 16 questions are like, you know, you have to one marker, no MCQs, no choice, as in no ABCD. Okay, chaliye. So next. For what values of quadratic? Also, the same thing. Why is it repeating? Okay, never mind. Chalo. Do this. This is 3 marker, guys. See, now here is the game changing. So what I have done is I have taken all the question paper, previous year question paper or sample paper, this thing. And then every year by year, these are all 2020 sample papers. Then we'll go to 2019 question paper. Then we'll go to 2018 question paper. Then we'll go to 2017 like that. Okay, do it. And quadratic equation, I don't think there will be a case study. Because a case study may, usually they will give either the coordinate geometry part of it, whatever they have given. So they will try to restrict it to. One reason is, or no, they can give you one question of 4 mark together, then there will not be any other question on quadratic equation. But then I think polynomials will be there for quadratic, for the case studies, and the mensuration will be there, right? So, but possibilities, you can never say zero possibility. Yeah. So, but I think for quadratic equation, they will go for 1+3 only. So hence, if 1+3 is there, then there's no case study. If one root of the quadratic equation is this, then find the value of P and the other root of the equation. Acha. Mistake people do here in such question. They will read here, read this also, but they will forget it. So my dear, what is the question? What is the way? Learn what are the demands of the question. So keep this in mind and write somewhere. Two answers have to be there. Okay, so hence, mostly I have seen people will write this P successfully. And because of, you know, your thought process says that, okay, there are lots of questions left to be solved. And hence, you will miss the other root of the equation. So hence, there are 2 parts of it. Remember, now how to do it. So in 3 marker, I will start.
Sir, P is -8.
Let me see. I will also solve. So I will start like this. See, in this question, please mark the steps. Sir, what should I do? No, don't get confused between, the moment you are seeing, this is an equation. There is no question of polynomial. This is a quadratic equation.
Sir, I just stole the answers for these questions.
What Tejaswini? Sorry, didn't get you.
I just stole the value of P and the other root. That's it, I told, sir.
No problem. See, you might be able to solve it in your brain, but...
No, sir, I didn't solve it in brain, sir. I solved it in book.
Good. But you have to follow few protocols, because this your copy would have been, let's say, your would be corrected by someone in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, you never know. So hence, it's better to, you know, write as per the demand of the board. Okay, so 3x square plus px plus 4 equals to 0. I will start here. One root of the quadratic equation is this. One root. I will write one root and I will put a comma alpha. Is equal to 2/3. So this gives an indication that you know alpha beta are the two find beta and what P, right? So P, how will you? So hence.
So yeah,
Oh my God. Mute yourself. P into 2/3. Mute yourself, guys. Hello. You want to mute yourself? Guys, hello. You have to. Who is this? Yeah, please do not play with your mic. If you're not interested, you may please leave. No problem, but do not disturb. Okay, yes, all of you. We want only serious people here. Okay, chaliye. So 3 times 2/3 whole square. Okay, and sorry. So try not to do overwriting here. I'm unable to delete. Why? Because I have to go for eraser and all that. So hence, don't do this. This is not good. Not good. Let me write. So if you are not able to erase, you simply cut. Okay. And then rewrite again. Once again, 3 times 2/3. Overwriting frustrates the examiner. So hence, please try avoid and don't do khichdi like this. Don't do this. This is all going to pull your this thing impression down. So hence, simple. If you have made a mistake, simple cut. That's it. No doing painting over there. Okay. 3 × 2/3² plus P times 2/3 plus 4. This is equal to 0. Okay, now, so hence you can see this is 3 × 4/9 plus 2/3 P plus 4. So this is 3, 3. So be careful with the calculations. So 2/3 P, or this is equal to 0, will be equal to -4 − 4/3, which is equal to −12 − 4/3. Yes or no? Admit. Yeah, correct, guys. So what is this? This is coming out to −16/3. This is 2/3 P. So what is P, my dear friends? P will be simply −8. This is one part. Do not leave the question and go to the next one. There is two. One is done in the mind. You know, one is done. Other root of the equation. How to find out other equation? Now you know that this equation is 3. So either you can do by sum of the root, you know, or you can now solve it. −8x + 4 = 0. This is the equation, isn't it? So either, what did I say? Either if you know the sum of root. So first spelling, sum of root, R-O-O-T, root, R-O-U-T-E. So sum of root is also possible. You can do that. Or if not, then you need to do what? Solve this equation. So 3x² − 6x − 2x + 4 = 0. Right? So you write 3x and x minus 2. Correct? −2 × −2 = 0. So this is x minus 2. 3x − 2 = 0. So you can validate also. 3x − 2 will give you this root 2/3. So hence x equals to 2 and x equals to 2/3. So write down. So other root is equal to 2. That's it. This will fetch you 3 marks. Okay. Now I have written it in 2 columns. You don't write it in 2 columns, right? In 1 column only. Okay. Fair enough. Okay. So next, this is done. This again copy. I don't know why. So every slide is getting copied twice. No worries. Oh, maybe some extra space for solving, and hence it is kept like that. Okay. Roots alpha and beta of the quadratic equation are such that alpha minus beta is equal to 1. Find the value of k. Solve. This is 3 marks again. Will these slides be uploaded? Yes, my dear. Slides will be uploaded. Don't worry. And where can we access it? You will be able to access it in the same Learnist, my dear, where you have seen the link. Anyways, roots, alpha and beta, all technical thing, you can talk to us separately. Okay. If, yes, guys, k is equal to 3. Akshita, you are trying to find out a and b. Dekho, pata chal gaya, where is the issue? Find the value of k. The question is find the value of k, nothing else. Hanji, so if you just write alpha and beta. This happens. I
saw that later.
Haan ji, yahi to kasht hai. And then you come back and then, oh my God. Ye wala expression. I know this expression. I have been through this. Sir, will we get extra questions as well? How many do you want? We will give you. Don't worry. Chalo. Roots, alpha and beta of the quadratic. How to solve? Steps. Roots of alpha and
beta. Sir, alpha will be −b/a.
Yes. So hence, here is a mix of polynomial and quadratic, isn't it? So you know that in quadratic equations or polynomial, right? If alpha, beta are the roots of this, then zeros of the polynomial. So you can also write alpha and beta are zeros. Roots of quadratic equation, if you saw above, these are now zeros of polynomial px, which is equal to x square minus 5x plus 3k minus 3. This is a polynomial. Alpha and beta are zeros of this, if alpha and beta are roots of this. So now what do I know? Alpha plus beta, in case of polynomials, if you remember, minus b by a, right? So hence, write minus, then write minus 5 again, then divide by a, 1. Write all of this. Don't write directly 5. Show them that you know. Or if you have time, write this. Minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. This is what is alpha plus beta. So hence, I get alpha plus beta is equal to 5. And alpha minus beta is given as 1. Now linear equations, 2 alpha, sum them, is equal to, and please do not write this. Sorry, my bad. I keep doing this. So write all of this too. You write adding 1 and 2. You will get 2 alpha is equal to 6. So alpha is 3. Right? Write 3. And then I'm again writing here. Don't write like this. Write in one column from, let's say, anyone you want. 2. From 2 and 3. 3. You can write beta is equal to alpha minus 1. Hence, it is 3 minus 1. Hence, it is beta is equal to 2. Now, what is find the value of k? So, how to find out the value of k? So, you now know product of zeros. Product of zeros. Alpha. Alpha beta is equal to C upon A, or you can write constant term, or you don't need to write this as well. You can directly hop on to what is constant term, 3 times K minus 1 by 1, but do write by 1 like that. So they will know that you are aware of this. Okay. So what is alpha beta, Guru? Alpha beta is 3 times 2. Isn't it? So write down from here. Oh, where did it go? Wait. So you write, again, I am, because of lack of space, I'm doing it here. Let me take it. Now, this is what? Alpha, beta. So you write 3 times 2. Oh, what's happening? Yeah. So you write 3 times 2 is equal to 3k minus 3. So 3k is equal to 6 plus 3, 9k is. Bolo dosto, any difficulty? So you now learned what are types of problems. Can you see so far? Now the problems are either to find out the value of k basis the nature of roots, or one root is given, find the other root and the other value, or you have to find out, let's say, using the sum and the product of roots, root. But that anyways will take up in polynomials once again. So hence I have not included that as a theory in this slide. Okay. Now, this is now previous year, 2020, actual board paper. If one root of the equation is this, is the reciprocal of the other, then the value of k is, right? Try, if one, this is one mark. So again, you know, not that intense. You can again use the sum and product of roots, root. I'm waiting for you all to solve. Aryan Tandon says k equals 4. Ranjini Ghosh says k equals to 4. Anyone else? 4, 4, 4. Okay, so easy, right? How did you do? Sum of root, root, or any other way? How did you do? Product of roots. Yes. So hence, why? Matlab sum and product of roots. So product of one marker. So I will directly write product. Don't write prod and all. Write full. Product of roots. Alpha beta is equal to, or you know, you can directly you should actually start from here. Let the roots be alpha and 1 upon alpha. If it is MCQ, so no problem, but if you have to write, then write. Let the root be alpha into root. So alpha times 1 upon alpha is equal to, simply write 3 upon k k minus 1. Be careful with the sign. C by A, so 3 by k minus 1. So 3 is equal to, so or one step more. So write 1 is equal to 3 by k minus 1. This implies 3 is equal to k minus 1. This implies k is equal to 3 plus 1, that is 4. Now, many a times people will make a mistake here. Error zone. Error zone is, what will you do? You will do this. That k is equal to 3 minus 1 and make it 2 and we'll get 0. So be careful. Okay. So calculation errors possible. Next. Chaliye. Now this was 4 marker in previous 2020 paper. So and this year there will not be any 4 marker question. So but then questions will be there. So let's solve. And I have seen a trend that in the last 3 years paper, there has been one question on speed distance time. Okay, so out of all different types of word problems, you can expect a question on time, distance and speed. Okay, so chalo. So how will you solve this? A train covers a distance of 360 kilometers at a uniform speed. Had the speed been 5 kilometers per hour more, it would have taken 48 minutes less for the journey. Points to be careful of. First of all, this unit is, friends, I normally say unit alarm. So the moment you see minutes and you should be aware that, oh, there is. So don't write 48 directly. People write equations using only 48. No, that will be one thing. Find the original speed of the, and always keep an eye on what to find out. Original speed. So what will be the variable? Oh my God. Situation problem using transformative equations are in single. You will not get equations wherein you have this kind of equations. Is that okay? But rest all are very much there. Is that okay? Yeah. So any equation of this form, which is reducible to a quadratic form, will not be there. But any equation which is directly into quadratic form will definitely be there. So this is deleted. I showed you, right? You can check on the website also. Only this is deleted. Chalo bhai. Solve. Done. So in these questions, usually, I would have drawn a diagram. Okay, how simple one like that. Okay, I would say this is A, this is B, and I would say this is D is equal to 360 km. Okay, original speed is R.N. Tandon has already solved. Okay. Had the speed been 5 kilometers per hour more, so we will start with saying this. See, now let's focus on the steps, guys. Let the original speed of the train be V. I am comfortable with V. You can take U because I'm a physics person also, so I usually take V. You can take U, X, whatever, right? No problem. So whichever variable you are comfortable with, let the original speed of the train be V. Now you have to directly jump on equations. So you can and also let the time taken by train at V, or you can write, let the time taken by the train to cover 360 kilometer at V kilometers per hour. Acha, yahan pe do mention this. Very, very important. Per hour. B TRs. TRs. Okay, my pointer nib is a little wider. So hence don't, this thing. So hence at times it might not be that clear. But never mind. Okay. Now, what do I know? So you can say very easily V times T is equal to 360, point number one, right? Next is, how do you write? You write, at the speed being 5 kilometers per hour more. So V plus 5 into T minus, obviously, for 48 minutes less. Now, 48 minutes is 48 by 60, my dear friend. That is important. And this is again 360, no doubt about it. That's it. These are the two equations. The moment you write two equations, you'll get 50% marks. Now you have to just solve for, eliminate T and solve for, right? So what will you do? So you can get a quadratic like this. So you can from 1, 2, from 1 and 2, expand this. You'll get VT plus 5T. VT plus 5T and minus 48 by 60 is what? 4 by 5. So minus 4 by 5V and minus 4. Okay, everybody is doing. Okay, everybody is able to solve. And this is equal to, I am writing VT itself. From 1 and 2, I have written here, so I don't need to explain this. From 1 and 2, is that both are 360? Is that correct? Bolo dosto, any problem? I hope this is cool. Correct? Correct or not? So VT and VT will go, and you'll get a relation between T and V. So you'll get 5T minus 4 by 5V, and you can write this as 4. Okay. Now you can use, so hence, you know, eliminate T. So T is nothing but 5 into 360 times V. Don't eliminate V because you want V. Minus 4 by 5V is equal to 4. This is the final equation. So now something can go, yes, 4, and here 90, right? So write clearly, and then 450 by V minus V by 5 is equal to 1. Cross multiply, I'm writing it here, right? I'll start from here. So you'll write, so what will this be? So 450 into 5. So I will write 450 into 5 minus V square is equal to 5V. Directly I wrote. Right. And then this is V square minus 5V minus 450 into 5. I'm purposefully writing like this. I don't want to calculate unnecessarily. Because anyways, I have to split the middle term. Okay, G. So 450 into 5 is nothing but 45 into 50. Dekho. Here is why I kept it like this. 5V is equal to 45, sorry, minus 45 into 50. I hope this is clear to everyone. And this is the catch. So hence V square, 45 times 50, you can write 45 plus 50V, sorry, ulta, minus 50V. Am I right? Minus 50V plus 45. Oh, plus 5 was that. Oh, did I mistake? Do a mistake. Ah, sorry. My bad. Correct. Thanks for highlighting. So this is, then it will be cut. Then write V square plus 50V. I was writing like that. 45V minus 45 times 50. Sorry for lack of space. Okay. Now you have to solve it. So hence V times V plus 50 minus 45 times V plus 50 is equal to 0. So hence write both of them, and I will write directly V is equal to 45, V is equal to minus 50 kmph. But you have to also write one more step. Where do I write? I write here. So let me put a star and write here. Okay. I will write write these steps also. Since velocity cannot be, or speed, sorry, not velocity, speed can't be negative. Hence, the desired result. Write like that. Clear? This should be this methodical. And I'll show you how people have done it in the past. Board has also released some sample model answers. You'll see that. Clear? In solving part, there is no issues, right? See, most of you are anyways are aware of how to solve. The catch is how to present it now in a proper way without messing up with data and getting it as per the norms, whatever they require. Bolo, clear? Give me a thumbs up. What happened to the energy level, people? All good? अरे कुछ तो बोलो यार. All good or not? If there is an easier way of doing this, please, you can. If you have easier way, you can do that. No problem. You can always, 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 if you think, if you're confident, there could be many ways. No problems at all. Okay. Is it fine? Yeah. Chaliye. Next. This is a previous question again. Previous year paper. Board paper 2020 or sometime back. Okay. Chalo, do it. This again, can you see that? Another question from actual board paper. And again, speed, distance, time. Same way. So who was saying there is another method of this thing? Oh, I forgot the name. Oindrila.
Oindrila, yes, sir.
Yes, Oindrila. You can tell us your method so that everyone else is also enlightened.
Sir, so basically in this speed, distance, time question, you draw a table of speed, distance and time. Sir, if you could draw it, it will be easy.
Yes, why not? Let's draw speed. Oh, you, what happened here? Wait. This is, speed, distance and, so speed, distance and time table. Okay.
Sir,
yeah.
Original duration. Okay, so in this case, we take the time to be x.
X. D is 360.
Yeah, so speed will be
360
distance
by
time, 360 by x.
Cool. Yes.
And time of the flight increased by 30 minutes. So x plus 30 by 60.
So x plus 0.5.
Yeah, x plus 0.5. Distance.
The same.
Yeah. The distance is 600 in this case.
Oh, I'm sorry. Watch. I was thinking of the previous question. Wait. So 600. Oh, watch. I could have done the 600 very easy. Look, let me delete only with painful technique. Is there pointer of eraser? Now pointer options. Pen. I hope I've got the same color. Yes. Bolo. So this is 600. And cut this and 600. Now?
So speed in this case will be 600 by x plus 0.5.
Its average speed for the trip was reduced by 200 kilometers per hour. Hena? So, and time of flight increased. Yes. So, what? Yes, tell me. So this is 360.
600 by x plus 0.5.
600 by. Oh, sorry. This also is 600. Sorry. 600 by x. And
600 by x plus 0.5, sir.
No,
in the second column.
No. 200 kilometers per hour, no? Minus 200 kilometers per hour. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This will be the table if you were going for the table route.
Yes, correct? Sir.
Hanji, sir. Next.
So now speed, the new speed with the second data will be 600 by x plus 0.5 is equal to 600 by x minus 200, and we simplify and get the answer.
Come again. Which are you?
600.
600.
600 by x plus 0.5.
No, what are you equating? Because our speed is 600x minus 200. 600 by x minus 200. This is the new speed.
Yes, sir. Its average speed was reduced by 200, right?
Yes.
So 600 by x minus 200 is equal to 600 by x plus 0.5 because that was the time taken, right?
600 by x minus 200 is the new speed, and you are multiplying.
Is equal to 600 by x plus 0.5.
Why will that? Oh, okay, like that. Okay. X plus 0.5. Okay. Yes. Correct. Yes. So
yes,
you can
sir,
equate and
simplify and we get it.
Yeah. So basically, you know, the thing is, Andrea, the thing is, sorry, who is this?
Oindrila.
Oindrila. Right. Now, the thing is, in this case, this is a trick for, let's say, MCQ based questions. We also adopt this. But in this case, my advice to all of you would be go for equation writing, write two equations and solve. My advice would be that. Because usually we have seen that in the model answers as well, that you can, you know, so that you reduce your risk of losing if at all there is a possibility. This is perfectly right. No problems in this. So you get the picture. Same. It is same thing in a, you are doing the same thing, my dear. How? What are we doing? We are doing this. In this case, what would have we done? We would have done this. So my original speed is V into T. Right? Now in this case, original duration has to be find out. So T has to be find out. Okay? Now V into T is equal to 600. The second equation is V minus 200 into T plus 0.5 is equal to 600. Right? These are the only thing which I have. Yeah? And then you equate the same thing. So you write what? VT plus 0.5V and minus 200T and minus 100. Correct? Check once again. Whenever you do, keep checking. So VT 0.5V minus 200T minus 100 is equal to VT. Cut. And now you will get 0.5. Now V has to be eliminated. So write 600 by T. Minus 200t, and this is what you are also saying, correct, is equal to zero. This is the equation. This is the quadratic equation, final quadratic equation. Solve for t. Okay, so 0.5 into 600 is 300, and thankfully we can eliminate all the 000. So you can see 0000. 0.5 into 6, there is an into sign here, is simply 3. 3 upon t minus 2t minus 1 is equal to 0. So hence, my dear friends, where do I write? Let me write here. Now, so put a star. Don't do this star thingy there. Okay. Write in one column. Be as clear as possible. Now, this is because one slide is there. So hence I'm utilizing the space as much as possible. So 3 minus, multiply the entire equation by t. So you'll get 3 minus 2t square minus t is equal to 0. So hence 2t square, be careful, plus t. Minus 3 is equal to 0. Did you all get this equation? So there is marks till this level also. Right? All of you confirm? Did you get this equation, guys?
Yes, sir.
So this is very easy to solve. 2t square plus or plus 3t minus 2t minus 3 is equal to 0. You can club these two and these two. Right? So hence 2 common, 2t common t minus 1. Plus 3 common t minus 1. So hence you'll get, again, this implies 2t plus 3 is equal to t minus 1. So hence t is equal to 1 or t is equal to minus 3 by 2. But again, you'll write what? Since time can only be positive value, time can have positive value only. Hence, t is equal to 1 hour. Don't miss the unit. So let me write it. Do not miss the units. You'll lose half mark otherwise. Do not miss the units ever. Aditya asking, if we get a negative speed as one of the solutions, we neglect it. Yes. In 10th grade mathematics, yes. Answered. Okay. So speed cannot be negative in our case. Chalo dosto. So this is done. Now next. Same again. So hence we are not going to, let's not spend time over there. Right? You'll be able to solve this. Will they ask velocities? No. So you are not going to have any vector related stuff. So they will talk in speed, distance and time only. This is speed, distance, time problem. So they are not going to ask you if the ball is thrown up, what will happen in, yeah. So those things are, so everything, whatever will be happening in a straight line in one direction only. So don't worry about these things. Okay. Next. Bolo, will you be able to solve? Chalo, dekhe. Solve it. I'm not going to solve now. You know the technique, you know the pattern, write step by step. There is no hurry. Take 2-3 minutes. This is a good, practice of, let's say, finding how much time you're investing in such questions. So try to find that question time also. So do it methodically and tell me the answer. Let's see whether everyone is able to solve it. Quick, guys. waiting for your response. Take time, but similar type of question, speed, distance, time.
Sir.
Yes, done.
One train is the original, one train is, sir, one, my headphones have fallen down. Speed of the slow train is 30 kilometers per hour, and speed of the other train, fast train, that is 40 kilometers per hour.
Oh, you. So Aryan and Monish are getting different answers. Check. Tejaswini.
I don't think so.
Check, check, check. Two people are getting the same answer. So Monish, my dear friend, without units, it will be difficult.
Sorry, sir. Sorry, sir.
Don't say sorry to me. I am not going to give you marks, bache. So be careful. There is no hurry.
Yes, sir.
CBSE 10th grade paper can be finished in 2 hours, 15 minutes, 20 minutes max. So relax. Now you know what kind of questions are there. So it's always an advantage. Yes, guys. Shall I solve? Akshita is saying 40 kmph. Anish, which is 550, achha, obviously 50, but units also have to be mentioned. So I hope you have mentioned that in the notebook. Okay, is 50-40 correct? Do I need to solve? Anyways, let me solve. So fast train takes 3 hours less than a slow train for a journey of 600 kilometers. So again, we'll start with, let us say, let the speed of a slow train. Chalo, we'll take your language. Slow train be X. KMPH. Okay. Like that you start. And a fast train takes 3 hours less than a slow train for a journey of 600 kilometers. If the speed of the slow train is 10, so it's given 10 kilometers less than. So the speed of fast train is equal to X plus 10 kmph. Okay. Find the speed of each train. So we have to X and X plus 10. We have to find out again each train. So don't only find X and be satisfied. Speed of each train, it says. Now it takes 3 hours less. So who will take less? Obviously faster train. So X plus 10 speed into T minus. Yes, my dear friends. Oh. Mute, please, guys. You have to mute yourself. Yeah.
I've done.
Yeah, thank you. Now, yes, X plus 10. And what? Achha, we have to also assume. So, please write that whatever you're using as a variable. So, T is, or you can write time taken. Time taken by slow train is equal to TRs to cover 600 kilometers, right? So hence the same type of question presented in a different format. That's it. So instead of the same train, they have given you two trains. That's it. Otherwise, the entire scheme is same. So X plus 10, T minus 3, is equal to 600, and X into T is equal to 600. Same two equations, you'll get one equation, and I'm not going for entire step. So these two equations and table method, whichever you find well. So X is coming out to be 40 kmph. So you can check whether it is correct or not. And the other one is what? X plus 10, fast train, how much? 50 kmph. All of you are getting this or any trouble, then I will have to solve the full equation. Bolo. Else we'll go to the other type of question, varieties of question. Okay. Clear, guys? Yes, so far so good. Slide number 22, or so 26 rather. 22 is the information, 26 is the slide number. All of you clear? Give me a thumbs up if everybody is there. What happened to all of you? So energy level should be back. Come on. Yes, thumbs up. Thumbs up. Say why. All of you will type why. So let me see the energy level. Energy level should never be down. Always up. Okay. So good that you are enduring this long hours, but our job is bigger. Okay. Do this. Now, nature of root in 3-mark setup. Find the values of k for which the quadratic equation this has equal roots. So they are getting nature of roots and solving a quadratic equation both together. So that's the beauty. So both the concepts are checked in the same question. Please solve and let me know. Oh, you have done it already, Arun. Good. Others also? Akshita is also done. Okay, so everybody is getting -3,5. Okay, so find the values of k for which the quadratic equation has equal roots. So again, you'll start with, where did the pointer go? Oh, here. Huh. So for equal roots, what do we will have? We will have, again, be very, very careful. K plus 1, B square minus 4, A, K plus 4, C, 1. Is equal roots, matlab D must be equal to 0. You can, if you want, discriminant, you can write discriminant, because we are not writing what is D, K and all that. So discriminant equals to 0. B square minus 4AC is 0. Correct? This is the equation. So hence now, is there any possibility without expanding? Yes, there is a possibility without expanding also. So you can write K plus 1 whole square minus 4 K plus 1 and how much? 3, no? Minus 4. So minus 12. Am I right? Minus 4, minus 12, minus 16. Correct. Correct, no? This is one equation. Okay. So hence, what can you say about it? 6 into 2. So hence, this implies, see, I never expanded it. So you can solve like this also. So 6k plus 1 plus 2. K plus 1 minus 12 is equal to 0, where my variable is K plus 1 now. Okay. Where did the 12 come from? Acha, let me solve this and I'll come back to where this, you know, basically what I did is, dekho, okay. From here, look at it. This is K plus 1 whole squared minus 4 K plus 1 plus 3 is equal to 0. This is what is given, Akshita. I simply put a bracket around it and expanded. So this is K plus 1 whole square minus 4 K plus 1 minus 12 is equal to 0. Bolo, sahi? All okay? Am I right? Why did I do that? I don't need to expand now. Why? Because now it is simple. Here, what do I do? I'll get K plus 1 common. Within brackets, k plus 1, minus 6. Then here, I will get 2 common, and k plus 1, minus 6 is equal to 0. So k plus 1 minus 6 is common, which is k minus 5. So this means k minus 5 k plus 1 is equal to 0. Correct? So hence k is equal to 5 or k is equal to minus 1. Right? You got minus 3. Oh, well, sorry, my bad. K plus 1 plus 3, my bad. Yeah. Oh, eraser. Eraser. So now back to pointer. K, because this 2 and this 1 will get added up. So 3. Correct. So k is equal to 5 and minus 3. You could have expanded also. So if it is appearing to be dangerous, then you expand it. So you'll get k square plus 2k plus 1 minus 4k minus 16 is equal to 0. This is another way of doing it. Your method. So this is k square. Then minus 4k plus 2k is minus 2k. And minus 16 plus 1 is minus 15 is equal to 0. And again, you will get k minus 5k plus 3k minus 15 is equal to 0. So k minus, sorry, this is k square. So k minus 5 plus 3 times k minus 5 is equal to 0. And you'll get the same thing. K minus 5k plus 3 is equal to 0. Okay. And hence, from here, same result, right? So both ways you can solve. Okay, next. Again, this is one mark. See, one markers are usually about finding the value of k. X equals to 3. Huh? Either one root or nature of root. So x equals to 3 given. Quick, jaldi karo. No time. This will be like 30 seconds, but with full awareness. Don't rush through. Okay, cool. Right, do I need to solve this one? I don't think so.
No, yep. Sir.
Good. Next. One mark again. For what values of k, the roots of the equation x square plus 4x plus k are real? So hence, if you mark the word here, see, values. So there will be more than one value. Anirudh says plus minus. No, it will be inequality. Anirudh. It will be an inequality, no? So the moment it is not equal to zero, the moment nature of root not, or they are not saying they are not equal. The moment it is not equal, then you know. It has to be greater than, less than, things like that. Okay, let's solve. So values of k, the roots of the equation are real for real roots. And it is one marker. So for real roots. Now I can see people are doing the same mistake. Everyone, lots of people are doing the same mistake. One mistake is now here d will be greater than equal to 0. First mistake. People are doing only d greater than 0. Equal roots are also real. Understood, dosto? So first mistake is this. It says values of the roots of the equation are real. Now real may only real is given, nothing else. So real roots are d greater than equal to 0. Equal roots are also real. So this will be the criteria. Not and not d greater than 0. Right now. So hence, if this is there, then b square, that is 4 square minus 4 times 1 times k, must be greater than equal to 0. That means 4 square is greater than equal to 4k. Right? So 4 is greater than k. Or k can be less than equal to 4. Okay, you can one marker, you don't need to check and all. So hence, if you adopt this, Anish is saying, sorry, greater than equal to minus 4. No, there is no k square term, Anish. Why are you saying minus 4 and all that? B square minus 4ac, simple, is greater than equal to 0. Why will there be 2? There is no power on k. Okay? So hence. Okay. Next. They will not ask you for quadratic inequalities. Rest assured. One marker again. Similar question. Reciprocal roots. Not clear previous question. What happened, Aryan? Unmute and ask. Aryan, can you unmute? Hello.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Go ahead. Bolo. What happened?
K coming being at the same time, how can it be greater than 4 and at the same time be lesser than 4?
Where did I write? I said k is less than equal to 4.
Okay. I interpreted.
Both are the same.
Just see, this is not an appropriate way of writing. So hence I turned it like that. Okay, so it is
sir,
about.
So why isn't it an appropriate way of writing?
The variable is, so they're asking about k. No, so you say, do you write 3 is equal to k? Or you write k is equal to 3? What is k equals to? So 3. What is 3. K greater than or less than equal to? So
we
what are the
k
values?
Is equal to 3.
So hence what I'm saying is, it's not that you'll lose marks, but so they're asking about k. So tell k is greater than or k, or this statement means 4 is greater than equal to k. But they're asking what is k. So k is less than equal to 4. These are the values of k, hence. Okay, next. Solve. This is also 3. Why are only 3? Slide number 23. So 3. Find the value of k for which the roots of the equation are reciprocal of each other. So reciprocal roots. Let the roots be alpha and 1 upon alpha. Therefore, product of roots. Is equal to alpha into 1 upon alpha is equal to what? C by A, K upon 3. Right? So this means 1 is equal to K upon 3. So K is equal to 3. Okay? So, ek ye bhi bata deta hun, I just tell you a trick. If there is reciprocal root C, they are A and C have to be equal. Reciprocal roots ke case mein. Sir, I have a doubt if I write reciprocal, always keep in mind, dekho, in case of reciprocal roots, A will be equal to C. A and C will be equal. Is that okay? Has to be. Yes. What happened, Srijani? You are saying, sir, I have a doubt if you write minus 4k is greater than equal to minus 16, you get k is greater than equal to 4 for the previous question, is it? Where? I have it. If you write minus 4k, where is that, Srijani? Minus 4k is greater than equal to minus 16, you get k. No. Oh, achha. I understood your problem. Dekho, my dear, if x and y are positive, let's say R positive. Okay. Then if let's say X is greater than Y. X is greater than, let's say X is greater than Y. but minus x will be less than minus y. So the inequality flips when you cancel negative sign on both sides. Understood? So if minus 4k is greater than or equal to minus 16, then if you cancel minus minus or multiply by minus sign, what will happen? 4k and then inequality will flip. Understood? So if you can't cancel minus, it is not equation. So you can cancel minus minus from both sides. No. So if you cancel minus from both sides or you're multiplying by minus one, both sides, inequality will change. Less than will become greater than. Why? Because if 5 is greater than 3, minus 5 is less than minus 3. Right? And vice versa. So minus 7 is less than minus 3, but 7 is greater than 3. So if you're multiplying by minus 1, the inequality flips. Okay, in case of inequality. Got it? So do not cancel negative factors in inequality ever. If you're canceling, change the inequality. Okay. Less than becomes greater than becomes less than. This is done, this is done. Next one. Now we are doing something which are, now this used to come a little while earlier. Recent years, 2018 onwards, we haven't seen an age-related problem. But then I thought probably you must be also thorough with all of this. So try this. Father's age is 3 times the sum of the ages of his 2 children. After 5 years, his age will be 2 times the sum of their ages. Find the present age. Hence, I have eliminated the digit wala problem and all that. Why? Because it includes 1 upon x plus 1 upon x minus 1 and, you know, things like that, which is, so wherever that is there, I have kind of not touched them, reducible form. Find the present age of the father. Okay, so how to solve this one? Let's quickly. Yeah, so hence, one is let the age of the father of the father. This is what I wanted. So be x. Okay, father's age is 3 times the sum of the ages of his 2 children. Okay, 3 times the sum of the ages. Let the sum of ages of children be y. So don't think that, okay, since it is a quadratic, so I can't use y and all. No, you use both, no problem. So let the sum of ages of children be y. So what is given? Father's age is 3 times. So x is equal to 3 times y. And after 5 years of his age, so x plus 5, his age will be 2 times the sum of their ages. But here you need to be careful. Why? Because sum of their ages will be after 5 years, 10 will be added because both will have 5 plus 5 each. Correct? Am I right, guys? Bolo. But this becomes this is not a quadratic equation, I believe. This is not a quadratic equation. Oh, I put linear wala. Chalo, theek hai, no problem. You can solve it. So, it was appearing to be a, but how? Okay, never mind. Chalo. So, x equals to 3y. Yeah. So, anyways, that also you can. So what was needed? X. So don't eliminate X, eliminate Y. So X plus 5 is equal to 2 X upon 3 plus 10. So you'll get X directly from here. Multiply the entire equation by 3, or you can first simplify 2X by 3 plus 20 and then multiply by 3. So I'm writing here, this will be 3x plus 15 is equal to 2x plus 60. So x is equal to 45. Oh, this was a linear equation. Sorry, no problem. Anyways, we'll cover linear equation later. So let's go ahead. Do this. A fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 2 is subtracted from the numerator, and it becomes 1 by 2 when 1 is subtracted from the denominator. I think this is also from the linear equation part. Is there a mix? Because x and y you'll be taking. Okay, wait a minute, guys. Just a minute. Leave it for some time. This is again plain left 30 minutes. Less than similar type of question. Again, 2018, you can see speed, time, distance. This is true 2014. So try this one. Sum of the squares of two consecutive odd numbers is 394. Find the numbers. This is quadratic. Sum of the squares of, this is little earlier, so in 2014, just in case they come back with these, then what will you do? Of late, we have not seen that. Show the father and the child age question again. Yes, I will. Just let me solve this and then come back to that. The sum of the squares of two consecutive. Done, guys. Struggling. Why? Very less people now responding. Hello? Bored, huh? Total bored. Okay. Come on. 13 and 15. Everyone is getting 13 and 15? Only few answers. Akshita also 13, 15. Everyone is getting 13, 15. Okay, so let the numbers be squares of two consecutive odd numbers. It is. So let the numbers be 2n plus 1 and 2n, or rather, why this? Simply. No, odd, so it is better. So let it be like that only. So let me, you could have taken n plus n, then that will be for even also. Wait a minute. Pointer options. Eraser. Okay. Pointer options. Pen. Okay. Let the number be 2n plus 1 and 2n plus 3. These are odd numbers, mix of real numbers as well as, or a bit of knowledge of real numbers anyways. So 2n plus 1, 2n plus 3. What is that? They are saying sum of the squares of the two. So 2n plus 1 whole square plus 2n plus 3 whole square. This is equal to 394. So you have to find out 2n plus 1 and n plus 3. Don't just find n. Be content with it. No. So let's square it. So this is 4n square plus 4n. Plus 1. And this one is 4n square plus 2, 3, 6, 2, 12. 2, 2, 4, 3, 6, 4, 3, 12. Yeah, 4, 12, n plus 9 is equal to 394. Check again. 4n square plus 2 times 2n, 4n plus 1, 4n square plus 2, 2, 4, 3, 12, n plus 9 equals 394. Correct. So hence we have 8n square. We have 16n and we have 1 plus 9, 10, and that is minus 384. Correct. Did you all get that or not? All of this? Oh no, I mean, we can cancel this also, but only 4. So this is 2n square. You can take 2n plus 1 and 2n minus 1 either. I just took like that. No problem. So no, it will not go by 8. It will only go by 4. Isn't it? So 8n sorry, 4n. And this will be minus 90. Oh, it will go by 8 also. Sorry. Uh-huh, correct. So 24. 4, 6 is equal to 0. It will go by 8 also. Sorry, my bad. So anyways, it will be n square plus 2n minus 48. Bolo. The x plus 1, since x is an odd number only. So why can't we take directly x and x plus 1? No, x and x plus 1 are not two consecutive odd numbers. Rn. Correct? X and x plus 2 will work. But then I am trying to, you know, just avoid the even number case if possible. Hence, otherwise you can try x plus 2 or x minus 1, x plus 1 also. Two consecutive odd numbers is given, no? Right?
No, sir. I'm saying if you just take x and x plus 2, then...
Since it is given odd number, so hence I have taken...
Yes, sir. No, sir. I'm saying that's why we need to take 2n plus 1 to ensure it's an odd number. If we just take it as x, it can be odd or...
Even. No, in that case, actually, you will see, you will end up getting this equation only. See, why? Because... The solution is fixed. So at the end of the day, it will be like that only. So because if it is even, let's say, then solution doesn't exist. So it will, the solution will come out as odd numbers only. Understood? So, and just to, you know, make sure that they are asking for odd, so we are giving odd, that's it. Otherwise, you can take x plus 2. What will happen? Check. If you check, you'll get the similar this thing, x square. X plus 2 whole square plus x square. Yes, no, you have to actually take 2n plus 1, 2n plus 2, like that. Make sure that they are odd. You can assume x to be an odd number, but not every x will be an odd number, right? So hence, this is 100% odd, no questions asked, right? So hence, don't take x because x can be even as well. How do you ensure that x is not even? Yes or no? So you make sure that whatever your variable is or whatever you are assigning this to, so that is odd. So it is odd. No questions asked. Okay. Now, did you get this equation or not? Ye bolo. Am I getting the right equation? 2n minus 48. Yes. Okay. So 8, 6 are 48. Clear? So n square plus 8n minus 6n minus 48 equals 0. So n times n plus 8 minus 6 times n plus 8 equals 0. Bolo koi takleef. Should not be any takleef here. No problem should be there. So hence it is n plus 8 and n minus 6 is equal to 0. So n could be minus 8 or 6. Yeah, good. Okay, good only. You can get it directly also because it's fixed. That's what I'm saying. 394 will work only for this case, and hence you are getting it. But just to satisfy the demand of the question, nothing like it. So it's not that you'll lose marks there, Aryan. Don't worry. Okay. So here. So what are the possibilities now? N is equal to 8. So n is equal to minus 8, sorry. And n is equal to 6. So hence the numbers are 2 times 8. Minus 16 plus 1, that is minus 15 and minus 13. One pair is this and the other pair is 13 and 15. Okay. Go back to age problem. There are lots of age problem, obesity, blood pressure. Which problem do you want to go back to? So, yeah. Sorry for the bad joke. This one? Okay. Yes, bolo.
For that, they will have to move forward. We have to move forward.
Who has to move forward?
If they want to go back to age problem, they can't. They have to move forward to go to age
problem. Oh, achha, age problem. Aray, that was a bad joke. Yeah. So I was talking about my age problems. So I am having all of these. You know? So... I'm getting bald. Why the hair on my skull is getting white, gray hair. All these are age problems. Yes, Aditya, sorry. We were just having some discussion. Bolo bhai, okay or not? Kya question? Got it? Okay, chaliye. Chaliye, doston. So where were we? This is done. One geometry problem also you cover here. Then I will show you the model answers. Is this 6 days problem? Ye jo hai na, these ones. 6 days problems I have just mentioned here. You just practice once, but it is unlikely to be asked. Why? Because the moment if there is a equation which is reducible to quadratic form is there, which I am assuming that they're not going to ask such problems, but you must practice it. But anyways, before that, this one, geometry problem. Do this geometry problem. There could be a geometry problem as well. Yep, folks, done. Okay, so shortest side and diagonal cool. So let's see. Diagonal of a rectangular field is 16 meters. In such cases, do draw a diagram, representative diagram. Label it also. Now what? Diagonal of a rectangular field is 16 meters. So, right, this is 16 meters. And 16 meter more than the shorter side. Okay, so let this side be x, shorter side. So this will be x plus 16. The longer side is 14 meter more than the shorter side. So mention everything on the this thing only. Find the length of the sides of the field. Length of the side only. So you don't need to give the diagonal. Where are they asking? Find the lengths of the sides of the field. Only this much. Yes or no? So we will invoke Pythagoras' uncle. So you will say by Pythagoras' theorem, x plus 16 whole squared equals x plus 14 whole squared plus x squared. Before you go for a solution, check once more if you have written the equation correctly. So the diagonal of a rectangular field is 16 meter more than the shorter side, so x plus 16. If the longer side is 14 meters more than the shorter side, so x plus 15, correct. Then find the lengths of the sides of the field. So you have to find out x and x plus 14, simple. So square them up. So what will happen? You will get x square plus 256 plus 32x is equal to x square plus 196, right? And what? 28x plus x square. Okay, so 1x square, 1x square will go. Fantastic. Now what? So take this on one side, so you'll get x square plus 28x plus 196. And if you are very prone to errors, you write like this, minus 256. And minus 32x. So that lesser error. And then, also let me write here. So this is equal to x square minus 4x. And my dear friend, how much? 56 plus 4. That is 60. Am I right? Right or not? Yes. Good. So 64. So x square, and it has to be what? Yes, 10 plus 6 is 60. So x square minus 10x plus 6x minus 60 is equal to 0. So hence it is x minus 10 plus 6x minus 10, 0. So hence x minus 10 is equal to 0. X plus 6 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 10 and x is equal to minus 6. So you can write, since what this thing is not possible, positive only, right? So hence your dimensions are 10 and 24. 10 and 24 are the dimensions. Okay, so we'll quickly now go to, dekho ye, this is important. This is actual board paper ka, you know, how people have written. Can you see that? This is one of the questions. Let the number of books bought by the shopkeeper be N. See, total money spent. Very clear. No, dekho, this thing here. Still, it is, you know, very legible and very clean, neat and clean, step by step. And see, when they are striking it off, strike with one line like that, right? So that people are very clear where to do what. The answer has been properly highlighted, okay? Since, dekho, they are writing, since number of book is a whole number, it cannot be a negative number, so can be ignored, hence n equals to 16. Number of books bought by the shopkeeper is 16. Final answer, like that. And this is one marker. So for one marker, what have they done? Dekho. So given, they have written so much. Given quadratic equation is this, where A is equal to B is equal to C and all that. I think this is not that much required. Okay, so you can then correct, directly go to for no real roots. And the person has highlighted this. This is also, you can avoid this. It's okay. Even if you don't write it, it's okay. But this is just to show that you know this. Discriminant must be less than zero. So hence D is less than zero. Even if you start from here, for one marker, it will make sense. And hence they have got, so this is x equals to k minus 9. So k should be less than minus 9, right? These are all not required. This is good enough. Okay, you can stop here, right? So this is how the model answers should be. So what are you learning from here? Dekho, neatness is definitely a factor here, whether you agree or disagree. Neatness. Second, steps. Don't jump on, you know, you just, right? So that will be very, very clear. Always, you know, summarize this thing. So summarizing means you highlight that this is what you are wanting. Here it is. Okay, so you can just highlight the answers. Highlight. So there's a thumb rule which I usually say, highlight the answers. Highlight the answers. There's a thumb rule for writing an exam, writing a theoretical exam. The more you make the life of the examiner easier, the more she or he will make your life easier. So hence, don't put the examiner under stress. Don't let him or her mine data from your notebook. Then you are risking your, let's say, scores, right? So hence, make it easier for them. They will make it more easier for you. And the moment they see the presentation, they create an image of the student in front of their eyes. And that's how, you know, so you're, even if you're very, very smart, very intelligent, but your writing and presentation is pathetic, they think that the child is insincere. And hence, usually, the human tendency would be that I will, you know, so for example, this neat handwriting, even if the person is not very intelligent, let's say, even if, then I am getting an impression that, okay, good, sincere work. And sincerity does bring some, what do you say, brownie points. So hence, yes, obviously your knowledge has to be expressed properly. First of all, you must have that knowledge that is there. But after that also, if you're not presenting it properly, because it is going to a anonymous, unknown, stranger examiner, it's possible that they misread you. Possible. And hence, you can lose here and there half a mark, and our target of 80 upon 80 is lost. So I hope I made myself clear. Any question, guys? So you now know the pattern of quadratic equation portions. You know what kind of questions are going to be there. You know that there will be one marker and a three marker. You know how to approach what type of problems will be there. So hence we say that it is at the end of the day, when you start writing marks, it will become so predictable that you will think that, okay, enough. Bolo, any question, any problem? So all this will be uploaded. The video will be uploaded on YouTube and the link will be shared in that Learnist course. So from so tomorrow on,
channel name?
I'm sorry, my channel name is Syntom Academy. So what you can do is you have to enroll there in that Learnist course. There is where every link, every resource, every PDF, every text, every document, every video, everything will be there only. So you don't need to. Even there is a drive link, it will be posted there only. So tomorrow's class onwards. So those who have been with us, there will not be any link shared in the group, guys. So you can just come at 3:30, log in there, and you can start attending the session. Is that fine? Okay, so...
Sir, one more time, can you say that from where we can get this video link?
Syntom Academy YouTube channel. So those who are anyways, those who have joined the course on our Learnist platform, they know how to do it. Those who have not, they can approach me or Ankur sir or in our, you know, you take down, you know, you have to, those who have not registered themselves for this, they can go to Syntom Academy's website here. Those who have not registered, please register, because then only you'll be able to access the, let's say some material. So here is our website. This one is Syntom Academy's website. Now here, what you need to do is, you need to go to this inquiry admissions. And here you fill the form up. And here you please highlight the course, comprehensive, this one. Revision program X10. Then only we'll get to know that you are interested in this program. Okay. So everyone who's interested can just do that. For those who have just explored our program and then want to join this. Okay. So I hope it was useful session for all of you. It made some sense to you. Keep consistently attending the sessions. Keep writing the mocks. As all of you know, the 10th graders, NPS students, and our students in Syntom Academy, they know that you have a Camon this Sunday. So those who want to write Camon can write Camon. Those who want to write mocks can write mocks. So that freedom is with you. You can write both if you wish. Okay, guys. So thanks a lot for your time. I hope.
Thank you, sir.
Sorry for the initial glitch which was there, because we were never expecting so many people to be attending it. I hope the momentum is continued. Keep working hard. Our best wishes is always with you. We will be working with you as well. Any issues, any problems, please reach out to us as quickly as possible and we will be helping you with that. What about NTSC mocks? They are going on, Aryan. All of them are there. So keep writing. Every week, NTSC, CBSE mocks will be there. So keep writing. There is no end to that till you finally write NTSC paper. So your call.
So this Sunday, we'll have Camon, the NTSC mock and the CBSE mock.
They are available. You don't need to write all of them together. They will be available for a good amount of time. So don't worry. So write one, whichever you want to write. All options are open. You write whichever one you want. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
And it will be available throughout the week. So write any. And anyways, now this is a holiday season. So you can utilize your Monday morning, Sunday mornings, all that, to write as many mocks. Always remember, the more the number of mocks you'll write, the better your performance would be. There is all no doubt about it. Theek hai? Chalo dosto, see you then. See you tomorrow with Ankur sir. We'll be taking up electricity tomorrow. And, let's see. Tomorrow, milte hain. Once again, target Syntom is the theme. So all of you should get Syntom. In Syntom, get Syntom. Bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.